Welcome to an exclusive skill-capped guide for BFA Patch 8.3. Throughout the final season of BFA, we'll be releasing select guides from our site here on YouTube. If you're interested in seeing more new content like this every week, alongside our exclusive matchup review series in which we cover in detail exactly how to win the hardest and most popular matchups, head over to skillcap.com. Hey everyone! Balanced Druids are one of the least represented casters inside of Arena, but that doesn't mean they're by any means bad. High instant burst damage, multiple schools of magic, all whilst being very durable, makes them great additions to certain compositions. And it can often be harder to counter and play around classes that you don't see that often. In today's video, we're going to be breaking down 4 ways to counter balance druids. Welcome to Knowing Your Enemy. Our first tip to counter balance druids is going to be all about Incarnation. Incarnation, if you didn't know, is Boomkin's strongest offensive cooldown and what enables them to deal insane amounts of damage whilst it's active. First of all, to counter Incarnation, we're going to have to first understand it, as Boomkins actually have multiple ways to proc this, which could throw you off guard. Obviously, they have their standard Incarnation, which increases the damage they deal by 25%, as well as giving them a bonus to haste on top of some astral power, which is why Incarnation is such a powerful cooldown. The other ways a Boomkin can proc Incarnation, though, is by either their Major Essence, Vision of Perfection, which will in turn proc Incarnation, but with only 35% of the normal duration. The third way that a balanced druid can proc Incarnation is with their Azurite trait Arcanic Pulsar, which after 9 star surges will proc Incarnation for a very short 6 seconds. So it's not every time that you see this cooldown that you should be playing around it. The time that it's most scary is when the standard Incarnation is up, which you can distinguish by the duration, which is 30 seconds. So seeing this and identifying it means it's time to play defensive. So what I mean by this is that you can either look to retreat behind the pillar, lock the Boomkin down with crowd control, or just trade out defensive cooldowns. However you look to play around Incarnation, recognizing when it's up and playing accordingly will greatly increase your chances at victory. Our second tip is to play around Root Beam. Boomkins gain a lot of strength when they're able to pair up their talent Mass Entanglement with their Interrupt Solar Beam. Root Beam, as it's referred to, will lock you inside of their Solar Beam for a full 8 seconds, leaving you unable to move, cast, or dispel yourself, and is an integral part of their kit to set up crowd control chains and create pressure. Well, there are many ways to counter and play around this as a healer. Druids obviously have the safety net of being able to shift roots, so they don't have to worry about this. Holy Paladins can look to pre-freedom, monks can use their Zen Focus T preemptively, and shamans can look to ground the root. Certain DPS classes can also help out their healer out of these roots. Windwalkers, Rep Paladins, and Hunters should all look to save their respective freedoms to use on their healer when he gets caught inside of a Root Beam. Demon Hunters can also utilize their reverse magic. Shadow Priests also greatly counter Root Beam. You can of course look to Mass Dispel it, obviously. But if you get interrupted or don't have Mass Dispel available, then Mind Control in the Boomkin will cause the beam to become friendly, allowing your healer to then be able to dispel his own roots and walk out of the friendly solar beam. Needless to say, playing around Root Beam and looking to counter it will greatly reduce a Boomkin's crowd control and thus pressure. Tip number 3, prevent cyclones. When playing against a Boomkin, you may often wonder what to interrupt, as with most classes that have multiple schools of magic. Well, balanced druids casted abilities honestly are not worth interrupting. Both Solar Wrath and also Lunar Strike do very minimal damage, with the majority of a balanced druid's damage coming from the instant ability Star Surge, and also their dots Moonfire and Sunfire. The most important ability to interrupt is Cyclone. Cyclone is one of the strongest spells in the game, and is an integral way that Boomkin looks to set up kills for their team, either by cycloning a healer or low cycloning a DPS. As I think we've all been in that situation where you're cloned on 10% health whilst the crowd control is then secured onto your healer and you just come out of the cyclone and die. So looking to save your interrupts or preventing cyclone casts from going through are going to be your best bet at countering a balanced druid. Which brings me to our fourth and final tip to deal with balance druids. This one only really affects melees, and that's watching out for thorns. Thorns is one of balance druids' biggest tools to combat melee, and can actually be close to their top damage if you don't watch out for it. What thorns does is deals damage to you every time that you hit the target who has thorns, and yes, druids can give this to their allies. It's often the case that the damage from thorns is heavily underestimated, and if you struggle consistently with balanced druids as a melee, then this is probably the reason why. Well, don't worry, there are a few counters to this ability. For example, if you have a purge on your team, you can remove it that way, as thorns is a magical debuff. Simply swapping targets or trading a defensive cooldown during thorns will also be a great way to counter it. It's also worth noting that warriors and windwalkers can actually use thorns against the target by either using touch of karma or spell reflect to reflect all the damage back at the target with thorns. Remember though, the damage thorns deals is magic, so if you're going to trade a defensive, things like Diffuse Magic, Cloak of Shadows, and Anti-Magic Shell are your best tools. Alright then guys, that's going to be our top 5 tips in order to counter balance druids. Hope this was helpful, and be sure to let us know what class you want to see next. Thanks for watching.